meeting of the Zoning Board of Appeals to order. Date is Thursday, September 17th. And what we have on the agenda tonight is just a, under other business, discussion and a determination if a new proposal is a minor or major modification for the previously granted special permit for an accessory apartment at 181 South Street. ZBA case number 15-04. Mr. Wise, the project proponent, is here. He has given us some new plans. We also got a packet of plans that we were able to review beforehand. And I think we've got new plot plans tonight of the process or of the new proposal. And these are stamp plans, whereas in the packet, I think the change was not a stamp plan on that. This is not a typical hearing tonight. Obviously, the public is not involved on this. It's discussions. If you would like, I can ask the project proponent, the board is amenable to it, to kind of run through what the proposed change is going to be here. Different from what we had voted on before in regards to the accessory apartment. If you'd like to run us through that, Mr. Wise?
Yep.
Can you use a diagram or describe for us what the proposed change, the proposed modification is? I think for me that would be...
Yes.
I don't know what the other board members think.
The plot plan, and then we'll go through the architecture.
Yes, I mean, what you know, whatever you think will be.
So, as you gentlemen are well aware, the case in question is under appeal. Long story short, after much ado, my neighbor and I had a meeting of the minds. I think he was frustrated with his perception of how the second driveway was handled. He still is frustrated with that, but he's given me a condition and we're working through the legal paperwork of settlement such that if I get rid of that second driveway, he removes his appeal. So that's what we're here for, is to try and see how you guys take that adjustment in summary. The first page on your diagram is purely a record of conditions as it is. It's very similar to the one we looked at in February of 2014. The only difference is it shows a little bit more rock formation on the north east side of the house, and that's primarily because we're going to have to do some work over there now as a result of the change that we're making. So we wanted the builder to know what he was dealing with. On a rock wall, from a conservation perspective, this has been reviewed with conservation. I have discussed it. I submitted the final plans to Chuck today. As I just finally got them all in email today that I could submit to him. But the Conservation Commission went through it, understood the change, and was accepting it as a minor change that did not require a major adjustment from their perspective. So what we're doing is, if you go to page 2 of the plan, of the plot that you have in front of you, actually it's probably best to start with page 3, apologies. Page 3 has what we agreed to. Page 3 is what I came forward for and what you voted in a 4-1 fashion for in the past. Page 3 is what the Board of Selectmen had approved. Page 3 is what CPDC had approved, all that kind of fun stuff. And on the front left of the house, if you're looking at the street, we had agreed there was going to be a new driveway to service the accessory apartment. So that's what we had agreed to. Now if you flip back to page 2, you can now see that driveway on the front left of the house is now no longer. So there will no longer be two driveways. And instead, what we've done is take the garage which was a two-car, was going to be a two-car garage facing the street. We flipped it 90 degrees, made it a three-car garage, and expanded the driveway out to so that you can actually get into the garage. That, in essence, is the summary of the major change, or in my mind, a minor change, considering the accessory is not really touched at all, in order to satisfy and close this appeal process. My understanding, and obviously I'll take your input, but a three-car garage is acceptable. It is the maximum size of Reading, but it is acceptable. And so what we're doing here is taking the driveway, no change in curb cut, which George Zamboris has reviewed and signed off on. I have a copy of that if you need to see it. There's no change in curb cut, but we're just going to take the driveway, swing it out. We're going to build a retaining wall because there is a bit of a 4 to 5 to 6 foot drop, which is another thing that you see on here as a result of the change in the survey or the update in the survey, which is why it took so long because they had to go out and measure the topographical. So we'll put a retaining wall and then the driveway will curve out and then curve into the garage as it shows. So in essence, we've given up the second driveway. We've expanded the existing driveway with no change in curb cut and made the current one-car garage, previously proposed two-car garage, into a three-car garage, rotated 90 degrees. That is the essence of the change. There are other minor changes I'm happy to review. As a result of working with Glenn and farming up all of the measurements and all the stuff that was conditional for his approval in the first place. But that's, in essence, what we're here to talk about.
Okay, thank you.
Any concerns, David? Questions, concerns?
Well, in determining whether an amendment is minor or major, there is nothing in our zoning bylaw that provides us with a guideline for amending a special permit, right? You got a a special permit for the accessory.
Special permit, but not a variance.
There is nothing that specifically, and maybe any further rewrites or amendments of the zoning bylaw could take this into consideration, because we sure didn't, regarding the difference between major and minor. What does provide some guidance, however, is in the sections for PRDs and PUDs, There are sections 11.2.3.3.10.1 and 2 that do provide some guidance as to what considerations might be taken into account by the permit granting authority, in that case the CPDC, for making determinations regarding whether amendments are minor or major. And I specifically looked to those in trying to educate myself a little bit about Mr. Wise's petition or
request,
I guess. It's not a petition. And the one thing I'm a little stuck on myself, if we're using that as, again, a guideline, because it's not technically applicable.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Is a major amendment includes but not limited to large changes in floor area, which I guess is a determination we might make. Site coverage, height, setbacks, or open space, large changes in the location of buildings, open space or parking, or large changes in the circulation system, and this is where this is the highlighted portion for the purposes, including number and location of access ways. That would be considered a major modification. In this situation, again, my opinion, we're removing an access way. So we are decreasing the number and changing the location on, as far as lot coverage goes, not the location of the curb cut, of the access way. So if we're using the guidelines related to major minor modifications of permits for PUDs, PRDs, those are guidelines, I guess, for us to be cognizant of in making our determination between minor and major. So that's where I kind of come down on it. So I cut and pasted it onto my mobile. That's why I'm looking down, and I'm not looking at text messages or messages from somebody else. I put it onto my mobile. So minor amendments, I guess are also defined as shall include, but not be limited to, small changes in floor area, site coverage, height, setbacks, or open space, small changes in the location of buildings, open space, or parking, or small changes in the alignment of minor streets and ways on the site. Now, reading those two in conjunction, leaves the definition of access ways, in my mind, a little bit ambiguous if we read those two in conjunction, because in a PUD, the whole access way is a driveway. Most PUDs, anyway. Access would mean the road, because you have, the PUD is its own road. I live in a PRD, so, you know, they consider my road a driveway. So, from that standpoint, it's not 100% crystal clear as to what the intent of that might be, whether access way means driveway, because in my case, in a PRD, PUD, driveway and road are used interchangeably, essentially, or whether those might be considered different. Access way is just a road, driveway perhaps not mentioned. So that's something that I'm working toward in terms of my analysis of the request.
Okay. Thank you, David. John, any comments? Questions?
Well, I had a similar concern, and the concern was with the driveway. The second driveway exists right now in the original granting of the special permit. And this is a very unique request. I don't remember ever being in a situation like this in over 30 years, where the board is being asked to, and I'm coming from a little bit different direction than David is, and I'm coming from the legal side of it. And the concern is the Board of Selectmen granted a second curb cut and driveway for the special permit. Unless the Board of Selectmen goes back and removes that themselves, because they're the only person, and maybe somebody can correct me, they're the only person that, or the only board that has access to roadways and or driveways. That could be hung in the future somewhere, not being utilized by perhaps this owner, but the next owner, and then they could come back and say, geez, I'm going to put a second driveway in, and you can't stop it because the Board of Selectmen back in 2015 granted it to me. And that bothers me a little bit. And I, too, looked for solutions in the in our present bylaws and saw the concerns listed. And in the PUDs for direction. And I guess what I was also looking at is, what do we do in a situation like that? But coming back to my major concern is, right now we have a substantial increase in the size of the proposed addition with the garage. We don't have a letter, more or less, of approval from the building inspector. I haven't seen anything to that point. The driveway's a second item. I don't see anything from town council suggesting that in the middle of a litigation, we have had issues or situations before where town council has come in and said, okay, we have a tentative settlement here, And here's some documents given to by both parties willing to subject to the board's approval. I don't see any documentation to that. Updated certified plot plan I can cross off. And now Mr. Weiss tells us that the Conservation Commission is involved in this, but hasn't given us a decision on this. I don't know what impact that would have on the final proposal that's before us in the minor or major decision. So right now I'm with the number of items that I have here, I'm having difficulty looking at the minor modification aspect of it because we don't have any documentation to fall back on to justify us considering it as a minor modification. So right now, that's where my thought is going.
Yes, Mr. Wise.
And Mr. Treniello, maybe you know as well, but my understanding with permits, especially with special permits, is they expire if they're not executed in a certain period of time. So I'm also, if necessary, willing to stipulate that I'll go back to the Board of Selectmen and say, I don't need this anymore, take it away. But I don't think I need to, because technically there's an expiration period, and we're almost 6 months away from that expiration period, if that's the case. That's one thing. The second thing is the PUD-PRD comparison is a significantly larger development process than this is. There's a reason why there's a change process in that, because it's so significantly larger. When you're doing a PRD, the accessway is the road. You have to build the road in order to get to a driveway for a house. The road exists already. We're talking about less than 100 feet by 12 feet of driveway that's a change. You know, in that regard, the lot coverage and whatnot that we went through with conservation, you know, went from actually slightly increased the lot coverage from like 16.7 to 19 or 20%, but conservation viewed that as a minor change with the stipulation that my final documentation gets to Chuck so that he can send that to the chairman of the conservation team. It's all in public record, it's all public notes, and that can be reviewed if necessary. If necessary, I can pull it up and see if it's been posted yet. I'm not sure if it has, but it has definitely happened. I wish I had that documentation ahead of time. That's a fair request, and unfortunately with the legal process and lawyers, as many times as I call them a day, it doesn't happen. In terms of the overall change in the size of the house, the actual accessory itself, the same square footage as it was before, exactly the same. The driveway itself, the garage itself, is 12 additional feet wider, 12 feet by 22 feet. Technically, it's not considered net. Technically, it's not considered gross, because it's not livable, not habitable area. So we can change nothing about the net or gross area of the house as a result of this change. Now, that's obviously, you guys have your things to worry about, and I totally understand that. I've been through the ringer and back on this, as have you, because you're here for the third time or fourth time on this particular deal, so I sympathize with you. I'm just trying to get to the point where all parties can agree on what I view as a rather simple change that doesn't fundamentally impact the accessory apartment itself. It just impacts where people that live there will park. And it does comply if you go down the accessory apartment list. One of the questions is there suitable parking? Clearly the answer is going to be yes, because now there is a third bay. There would even have been suitable parking if I just removed the driveway on the other side and they parked in the existing driveway. So this gives us a better functioning and flow, and have no tandem or parallel parking type issues to go through. So I think your concerns are valid, and potentially we can talk about approval dependent upon X, or if you're willing to go there. But I think there's a fundamental difference between a PRD PUD and the process there, and the size and scope of that project versus the size and scope of taking a two-car garage, flipping it around, and making a three-car garage. Just fundamentally different in size and length. Ultimately, you guys are the ruling board, and you guys have to be comfortable with that. Just that's my answer to those first two questions. I don't know if I addressed everything, John, but I think I addressed almost everything.
Do you, sorry, can I interject a couple of questions? Is that okay?
Sure.
You have something in writing from any of the attorneys that are involved in the matter that says, if this, then we'll dismiss?
I have a draft settlement that my attorney has sent to Mr. Webb and his attorney. I talked to Mr. Webb on Tuesday, and all he can do is take my word for it, but we haven't sworn ourselves in. I'll swear myself in, if necessary.
Yeah, it's not sworn testimony.
It's not sworn testimony, but I talked to him on Tuesday, and he said, yeah, you did what I asked you to do. Fundamentally, I agree with it. There might be some legal I's and T's dotting that my attorney's doing to send back to your attorney. That's where we are right now, is a legal I dotting and T crossing in order to make that happen. But the stipulation he wanted was to give up the second driveway. The only way I could think about doing that without completely blowing ourselves was to flip the garage. I wish I had thought about that 6 months ago, frankly, because we probably wouldn't be here. But I kept thinking, there's no way I can get more people parking there without having a constant back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. And I couldn't go out further because it would have landed up on their land, so I had to flip it. The only way to do it was to flip it. That just kind of came as a brainstorm.
And, okay, thank you. And in terms of the special permit that this board approved,
yes,
that special permit granted it in conformity with, what was it, page, the last page that you showed us?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
That, so that's the modification that you're asking for would not only amend the decision, it would amend the exhibits to that decision, because we'd be granting you a decision based upon a new plot plan.
Yes.
Removing the driveway and adding the garage and the small other,
yes,
changes, the retaining wall, et cetera, et cetera.
Yes.
All right, just, you know, computing,
thank you for,
that's all.
Yep,
thanks.
Clarify as much as necessary.
Okay, thank you. Sorry for going backwards.
It's all right. We'll try to be pretty informal here. Sai, questions?
No, the one thing that bothered me about the whole thing is, how do you define a major and a minor modification? And I listened to your explanation, and looking at other districts and using what they're saying as a guideline, but I still have a little bit of a problem with that, because that kind of a district and this kind of a district are not one of the same thing. And so I think it's, to me, it's left to my own judgment as a member of the board to make my own judgment as to whether I consider it a major or a minor. There were a lot of other issues that John put on the table, our thoughts, concerns. But what we're being asked to do tonight, in my understanding, is what you want to change, major or minor. Okay? We're not modifying the permit tonight. We're just making a determination. And if we determine it's a major, then you've got to go do something. If it's minor, you've got to go do something.
That wasn't my understanding when I asked for the meeting.
And somewhere along the way, it seems to me you're going to have to go back and ask for a modification of a permit to be approved.
That was what
some
I
time ago
requested.
In such a manner.
Yeah.
Okay? And we're not granting anything tonight other than just making a determination as to whether it's major or minor, and that's going to be a judgment call on the part of each individual member on this board, I guess, with his own set of criteria. So that's all I got right this moment.
Okay.
That was not what I understood at all.
Eric, would you like to comment on this?
So I come kind of on a different route, and just because what they're looking for is the modification of the special permit. And I think that the petitioner has laid out pretty clearly and convincingly that the addition that he's proposing, or the modification that he's proposing, will in no way impact our analysis that we granted the special permit under. So I had no problem. If we're concerned procedurally, I mean, if, and I don't know if this is the case, that the petitioner does need to come back, we could in the interim maybe ask town council for an opinion letter as to procedurally evidentiary matters that we need to resolve. But I think if tonight you were to ask me, is this major or minor, I would say it's minor.
Okay, thank you. Look through this, and like I think everybody else that has looked at it on the board too, there really isn't too much guidance in the bylaws in regards to definition of a major versus a minor modification in regards to a special permit in this case. Like Cy, I feel it's basically an individual determination as opposed to going through a checklist like you might see in the PUD or the PDRs section. I don't think personally they're relevant because we're not in that district. You know, obviously you can use them and look at it and see, well, what would they require or what they consider a major, minor, etc. But I think this comes down to, it's a personal opinion in regards to that. And going back and going through the checklist or the section that we issued the special permit for the accessory apartment, I don't see that really anything has changed in regards to the special permit issued for the accessory apartment. What is being proposed, I feel, is an expansion of the garage over there, an elimination of the driveway that was on the, what would it be, the westerly side next to the accessory apartment. And I believe that the garage could have been, by right, he can build that right tomorrow. He could start on that if he wanted to. Get a building permit on that. He meets all setbacks. I haven't heard anything from the building inspector. I know, you know, it's usually he sends a memo on these things, and I know he's been out. I think he's
on vacation.
Yeah, he's on vacation, and he's been out over a week now, I believe. And
but he's usually tomorrow. I mean,
yeah,
or Tuesday. Back today or something.
Yeah,
he's back on Tuesday.
Right. But, you know, and we could get his opinion, but I think a lot of times it just all boils down, he does not vote on this. It comes to the members of the board. And my personal feeling is this I consider a minor modification. He's eliminating the driveway that he had a curb cut for. Now, what happens to that curb cut? Now, you notice, I don't know if that's a special permit that's issued by the selectman, and I don't know if there's a cutoff date.
So that's a good technicality that it...
You might have to check on that,
things, it's
yeah.
Not a special permit, as far as I can tell.
Right. Because we've run into...
the property, I believe.
Yeah. We've run into cases...
Now, the other thing is, I have not technically pulled a permit.
Yeah.
I received the approval to pull a permit.
Right.
But I have not technically pulled a permit. So if I, as I said, if a stipulation of your agreement means that I go before the Boulder Selectmen and say, by the way, that you know driveway you agreed to,
mm-hmm.
I'm no longer doing, so you can wipe it off your records.
Yeah,
I'll do that. I don't have a problem with that.
It may just take something by your attorney to note that you're going to consider that null and void or something to that effect. I don't know.
Part of the settlement, it doesn't necessarily.
Yeah.
Let me pull
it up.
It is not,
you know, maybe something no longer be an encumbrance on the property or something. I don't know.
Is what the Board of Selectmen granted to you recorded at the Registry of Deeds?
No.
So
it's not.
Though, and I know, you know, in past cases, Mr. Wise, we've run into, and the one that comes to mind is the 186 Summer Avenue. When we voted on that, the argument was that there was a curb cut there, though it was never employed as a driveway.
Right.
But the curb cut had been there for years, and it had never been used as a drive. Just the curb
but
cut.
But could
was there.
Have been used.
It could have been. Could have been.
The curb cut doesn't. You have not made the curb cut.
Well, yeah. There's no curb to cut. In my
well, you know
opinion,
what I mean. They
haven't
no installed the curb to show that that's a
there
driveway.
Is no curb. Yeah.
There's been no curb installed or anything. There's been nothing registered with the Registry of Deeds about
right.
it. There's been nothing. All the registrations are waiting for the appeal to finish.
No.
When the appeal
exactly
finished,
yeah.
that'd be
yeah.
my point exactly. That until this litigation is completed, nothing's going to be done. It's just like
right.
in limbo
right.
until this has been resolved
right.
before they can move forward on anything,
yeah.
including the curb cutting the driveway.
I would like to see that resolved somehow, but
let me see if I can. This is the settlement that's drafted. I can read it if necessary, or you guys can look at it if you like. You want me to read it, Mr. Inferno?
Yeah, why don't you, sure, give us a brief reading of it there, now we don't have to pass it back and forth.
That way you don't have to pass it around, right? It
yeah.
says, because you guys are listed as in it as well, right?
So, exactly.
Right.
So it's Michael Webb and Leon Webb plaintiffs versus Robert Redfern, Demasse,
Colette.
Eric Hagstrom, David Traniello, John Jarema, Kathleen Hackett, as members of the Zoning Board of Appeals from Town of Reading, and Thomas F. Wise of IM Wise, trustees of the Wise Living Trust. Defendants. The settlement agreement. Whereas Thomas F. Wise and IDM Wise, trustees of the Wise Living Trust, Wise resided and owned the property at 181 South Street, Reading, Massachusetts, the Wise property, and whereas Michael Webb and Leon Webb reside at and own the real property at 224 Walnut Street, Reading, Massachusetts, which property abuts the Wise property, and whereas the Zoning Board of Appeals for the Town of Reading has issued a special permit to Wise to construct and create an accessory apartment on the Wise property, the special permit, whereas Webb has appealed the special permit to the Superior Court in the above captioned action seeking to have a special permit annulled, and whereas the Webb and Wise's, probably what one of the minor changes is going to happen, desire to resolve the above appeal without further litigation or expense to either party, now therefore in consideration of the mutual covenants herein contained, Webb and Wise agree as follows. Wise agrees to waive and disclaim any and all rights to construct the second driveway entering on the northwesterly corner of the Wise property as approved by the Zoning Board of Appeals and the Reading Community Planning and Development Commission, and will not construct the same. One of the changes is the Board of Selectmen is going to go in there as well. Wise agrees to seek a modification of the special permit from the Zoning Board of Appeals as its meeting on September 17, 2015 to reflect the removal of the second driveway from the scope of work permitted thereunder, and will record the amendment at the Registry of Deeds within 14 days of the expiration of the appeal period related to such modification. Webb agrees to withdraw the above captioned appeal by stipulating the dismissal of the appeal with prejudice and without cost to any party, waiving all rights of appeal. Webb agrees not to oppose and to waive all rights of appeal relative to Wise's request for modification of the special permit as described in paragraph number two above. And that, as I mentioned, there's some things they're tightening up and tuning up in that, but that's the essence of it. The driveway is specifically excluded as part of the settlement.
Mm-hmm.
See, you're represented by counsel.
I'm represented by counsel, and you are as well.
Right now, we don't have counsel that is telling us what to do. The Webbs are represented
so
by counsel. You're coming up with an agreement. This board, which is all of us individually or as a board, has not been told exactly how to approve this. Consequently, we're stuck in a situation. I like to tell you the truth. I like what suggestion that Eric made, and that is we put this off to the point where town council, if this is an agreement, all three parties representing the three different entities come to this conclusion and sign off, then we could easily come back and do this. I would prefer not to rule on either this evening, and let the individual counselors go ahead, resolve this, come back, give it to us, and then we can move. I mean,
it's supposed to be done by now, but unfortunately it's stuck.
Have either of the attorneys, either yours or what's his name, Demora, attorneys talk to town council about
yes.
this proposal?
Yes. Mine has for sure.
Do you
know? The only reason we're here, I mean, I don't know, you saw the email trail that started this meeting.
I
right?
saw some of it, yeah, I think I saw it.
The only reason we're here is because town council provided enough back to Jean that she would allow this meeting and that the review of the process was okay. Now, clearly something happened when, you know, Jean was rushing around to get out of vacation, Jesse left, and, you know, Glenn left, and communication happened where we had gaps in communication and whatnot. But before we could schedule this meeting, Jean and Bob wanted town council's opinion that we could have this meeting and that we could move forward with the settlement agreement that my lawyer talked about with him. So, yes.
So we would, I guess what you're saying is we probably wouldn't be here if...
Mm-hmm.
Daytime government didn't get advice from town council.
You wouldn't be.
That
you wouldn't be.
We could be.
Yeah.
So that's, while that's not written approval of what's going on, that's pretty darn close to, you know, their kind of
right
blessing.
Right. And we don't get too many of these. We've had a few, I can recall, John, on major minor modifications. We get once, maybe one every other year, every third year or something.
What's the change that you're making in the parking? You're just, by removing that driveway was going to lead up to another parking
That driveway was
space.
Going to lead up, at the end of it was going to be the parking space.
The parking space.
Right.
They were
going to
park
and
in
so
that driveway, yes.
One, I mean, how much parking would be allowed in that driveway? You could park all the way down that driveway, I suppose you could, right?
Well, yes and no.
But you're,
theoretically, yes. But if you remember right, if you remember the bylaw as it is, there's no parking allowed in the front yard.
Right.
In the front
yard.
So we've had discussions about what the front yard is and all that stuff.
Yeah.
So what we wanted for was so that it could go all the way back so it's parallel with the house, and that was the part we were concerned about.
Your intent, however?
My intent, however,
was
to make sure they parked as far down the driveway as possible. One spot. Only one car.
But it is 10 foot wide.
Yeah, because that's the standard driveway cut, according to George.
And so by this change is basically taking that one parking space and moving it to the garage.
Yes.
Basically.
Yes.
Increasing the garage. So.
Yes. I mean, what Mr. Redfern said is also very true, and I did review this with Glenn. Unfortunately, it was before I had the final plans and before he could officially send you an email and all that kind of fun stuff. And there's a couple different approaches I can take here. And what I wanted to do, and I seem to be getting bit by Brent to do the right thing on a regular occasion, but what I wanted to do was get everything I's dotted, T's crossed before I start. What I can technically do is when this settlement is filed and the appeal is closed, I can go get the building permit for what you guys have already approved. And then come back for a minor change after that, because the accessory is not changing at all, it's just the garage is changing. And you're right, the garage is not under, other than the fact that sufficient parking is necessary, it is not under the accessory bylaw as it is. It's separate and distinct, and the maximum is 3, which I'm complying with. There's not going to be 4 bays, the maximum is 3 bays. I could, as you mentioned, knock down my garage right now and do that process separate and distinct away from everything. So, yeah, it's kind of, I mean, the accessory, the only reason I ever had to come before you was not the driveway, was not the garage, it was the accessory apartment itself. And that change is nil and none itself, the accessory itself.
Okay, thank you. Basically, that's the way I've been looking at it. Now, as I was saying before, we've had these in the past, not too often, major, minor. I know John's concerned about advice from counsel. I can't recall that we typically do get advice from counsel in regards to a major and minor change. It's up to the board.
No, the only time town council gets involved is when litigation is pending.
Okay.
And litigation
in this particular case, it's the others we have had.
Yes.
Yeah,
right.
Litigation was not involved.
They've asked for modifications,
right.
Just as a matter of
as
course,
a matter
not
of course,
as a matter
right.
of
litigation.
Settling
litigation,
act of litigation
to settle
the town.
Litigation, right. Right.
Technically, I could take it as a matter of course as well.
Yeah.
I could settle separately and then come and take it as a matter of course.
You could do that. You sure could.
Yeah. Well, if anybody would like to comment, they're certainly welcome to. I don't believe I've changed my position. I consider this a minor modification, and I would be ready to vote tonight on this if need be. Eric?
I feel the same. I mean, Mr. Wise, as long as you know that we can only, the relief that you've asked for is a determination of a major or minor modification. If we give you whatever we end up voting on, you would have to, I guess, risk going to Glenn and saying, oh, you're going to go back because the plans have changed. But, I mean, my feeling is that, you know, we're not modifying the special permit at all. So you would probably be able to work that out with him, but no one can give you that guarantee that you won't be able to work here again.
So as a matter of course with the Conservation Commission, if it's a minor modification, there's no further meetings of conservation. Chuck is the only one who has to take care of everything. Is that the case here if you guys determine it's minor as well? Or do I have to come back and say and present anything else further to you for a minor change? Because what I'm going to present is what you're seeing. I'm not going to present anything else. What I'm going to present is what you're seeing.
Yeah, no.
Not that I know of. If it's determined by vote that it's a minor modification, that would be it as far as, you know, what you're asking for tonight. If it were a major modification, it would have to be a whole new hearing. Yes, yes.
Would we at all consider, if we were to agree that it was minor, adding conditions to our decision? Because we're only being asked for major versus minor.
Right.
And we may think that it's minor as long as we have those other rules.
Yeah.
Concom, you know,
sure.
Final sign off. Right. Perhaps a Board of Selectmen's notation in a minutes that, you know, because one, if I heard what you read correctly, you're waiving your right to utilize that second driveway. But I don't know, I just don't know, whether or not the Board of Selectmen has a preference for what they do in a situation like that. Would they want to take the right away from you if you're waiving it? Do they have to, on the record, take it away from you? As if you're waiving it today, does that mean, you know, I mean, it expires after a certain amount of time, I think.
I'm not sure it does.
I'm not sure either. I know
and
you
so
mentioned
if you waive it now.
So the special permit's expired in 2 years.
Right, but they're not, but it, they
yes.
didn't give you a special
if it's
permit.
Not in the
yeah,
way.
Haven't started.
Yeah,
so the ironic
right,
the part
you,
of all of this.
You haven't started.
The ironic part of all of this
yeah.
is that most of the contention by my neighbor about it is that he didn't get sufficient notice for it, but it's a permit, not a special permit, which means he doesn't need sufficient notice for it. So,
but
in order to settle it and not be in 2 years of litigation for any of us, I'm just giving it up.
Yeah.
Right?
But he's the
yeah.
one with the lawyer, right? So,
he's the one with the, I have a lawyer too,
yeah.
argues against
but
it,
I'm
right?
Just saying,
and you're a lawyer, you can argue against it.
He's
two
the
years
neighbor with the
lawyer. Right, exactly. So that's what I'm saying. I'm giving
look
I'd
at
like
it this
to give
way,
it up. I'd be happy
think,
to go before the Board of Selectmen and say the same.
If a modification, if it's voted tonight, either way, if it's a minor, and David's talking about with some conditions on it, I do believe, correct me if I'm wrong, that is an amendment to the original decision, which then goes to the registry. That's filed at the registry to go along with the original permit, does it not?
I'm trying to remember to the last modification that we did, how we wrote it up. I think we actually wrote it up as...
It doesn't just get put into the case file at Town Hall, because
right, that
the
amendment
original
is actually... Well, the decision of minor actually amends the original decision.
Yes.
Because if it was major, you'd have to come back and,
right.
and open a new case. By deeming
right.
it minor, we are agreeing to
there you go.
His
yeah.
amendment, essentially.
Yeah.
That is what happens with Concom as well.
But, so,
and
again, I'm going from memory.
Right.
I have a fundamental problem with my mind right now, and that is I'm getting the impression we may be overcomplicating this issue, okay? I mean, there's a lot of things, you bring up a lot of things, and you have a lot of things, and we could add conditions to something, but conditions to things if you don't know exactly where they stand and all that sort of stuff, and I still get back to the very basic thing. He's trying to ask us whether we think this is a major or a minor change. That's all he's asking.
Well because if it's a minor change, then what? Sorry.
Huh?
If it's a minor change, then what? What consequence?
What do you do?
He's still got process to go through.
As far as we're concerned, what does that mean for us?
I'd say that we're off the hook.
But what does that mean for our original decision? Who's gonna amend that decision? Are we amending that right now by agreeing that it's a minor modification? We're agreeing to the proposed amendment. However, the bottom line is he's not amending the accessory apartment.
Right.
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 However, the requirements for the accessory apartment were spelled out in that laundry list of things, as well as in the application for a special permit, meaning a plan, sufficient parking,
right.
All those things that essentially haven't changed.
Except that the site plan
accompanied
that
accompanied
original
changes. So By agreeing that it's a minor modification, are we just saying, okay, use this site plan, presuming that everybody else that needs to bless it, blesses it?
No, because, you're a stickler for having a certified plot plan by a land surveyor or certified engineer, correct?
Yes.
That's what we have here. One of the criteria of the accessory apartment is proper parking. It is a major issue. That makes it a major modification if you're going to change that. So if we're agreeing to a minor modification, you have to adjust the original decision that the board made, and you need to file it.
Oh, I agree that whatever's decided tonight has to be written up and filed. And this plan should accompany that, the new site plan, stamped site plan. Now, whether you consider the driveway a major or a minor modification, he's eliminating the driveway on one side of the dwelling and actually adding it to the other
increasing
the other side, adding it to the other driveway.
But that's the major modification aspect of what we're trying to decide tonight. I look further down the road because I've seen over the years that things get kind of lost in the translation. And what bothers me, beside the bug, what bothers me is if we don't take care of this driveway appropriately, maybe not Mr. Wise, maybe the next owner, the owner after that, is going to put a driveway out there, and it's going to impact perhaps the traffic flow down the road. And somebody's going to say, well, why didn't somebody take care of that way back in 2015?
Yes.
And that's all that I'm trying to do. I'm trying to say, how do we get this corrected so that it goes into the books correctly so that we don't have a problem down the road? That's why I'm asking that.
Right.
Right now, to me, this is a major modification because we have not determined what the status of the parking is going to be. I know what the petitioner is asking for. I know what the other individual that started the litigation was after. Now all we have to do is to find a solution to that. And that's why I said I'd rather lean toward Eric's initial proposal, and that is not to rule on it. Well, I don't know if I'm putting words in your mouth, but not to rule on it and allow some of this to take care of itself down the road. And then the modification, you can start the process, come back for the modification. The modification's been taken care of. All we're doing is saying, okay, we're signing off on it. Just like planning board, just like a conservation, just like anybody else. Or, as David suggests, rule it as a minor modification, but put in the conditions that you want to have completed before it becomes a minor modification. But it still has to be recorded someplace down the line.
So I agree with the recording 100%.
I think it does.
I agree with that. And
I think the new site plan will take care of the parking. The new site plan that supersedes the original one.
And the settlement.
Now shows this is the new layout. The driveway's here. There's no driveway there. This is it. Now, what happens in town in regards to that?
Let me ask you, that the board makes a ruling as a minor modification. You don't like that bug any more than I do. we make the decision as a minor modification, and conservation comes up and says, oh, you can't quite do that. You're going to have to modify it, and that's going to cause you to shift the garage a little bit more, and we're going to need something else down the road from you, which impacts this again. Then what do? We meet again and do another modification?
Well, I think we would. Yeah, it would be like anything, John. You approve a modification, and then down the road you come to an unforeseen circumstance, and it has to be modified again. If it's felt it has to come before the board again, you would again. Now, is the new modification, is that major or minor also? I don't know. We don't know what's going to happen in the future. But right now, all we know is what we have in front of us.
Well, and the petitioner, the permit holder, has chosen his path. So if we rule on it right now and somebody else tells him that he's got to make a change that impacts our ruling, he's going to come back.
He would have to.
He may have to come back at a completely new hearing.
Well,
depending upon what is ruled down.
Well, again, so we rule now.
Right.
For instance, we rule now. One of the other boards or committees in town makes another change, and he needs another modification. He's got to come back and ask us for another determination, whether that's major or minor, with amended documents. And at that point in time, we determine what, if any, changes those other boards or commissions have made, make it major or minor.
Can I comment real quick?
Yeah, sure.
To Mr. Tranio's point, we're in a bit of a chicken or egg. You know, we'll approve if they approve, they'll approve if we approve, we'll approve if they approve, if they say no, we won't say, I mean, that's where we are. And when we were going through the bylaws review, one of the questions I asked is there an ability for a town member to request a meeting of all the boards that are impacted at one time so we can get past this? Because what you're facing, what you're telling me is I won't approve until they approve. Fortunately, in my case, they have approved. It's just a technicality of the paperwork right now. But this is insane from an end user perspective. If there's so many dependencies on different boards which are inbuilt, and we won't approve until they approve, and they won't approve, then we're going to be in this forever. And so I respectfully submit that, yes, I've chosen the path to get conservation's approval, which I have, and it's being filed, and it will be filed with the approval on the board, on the deeds. And then I'm coming to you to get your approval. And if a condition of your approval is I go before the Board of Selectmen, or for that matter, the CPDC, and say, I'm giving up that. I no longer need that 5 feet of grass. And Board of Selectmen, I no longer leave that curb cut, then I'll do that. But ultimately, I'd like to get away from the chicken thing and just say, guys, what do you think this is? Is this a minor change or a major change? Humbly, I submit it's a minor change, but that's your decision.
And again, you know, I'm not trying to make this any harder than it's been on you.
I know you don't.
You know, we've been, like I've always said to you, we've seen entirely too much of each other in these type of scenarios over the past 2 years. Typically, we're the last board that is asked to rule on these types of issues after all the other boards have given their blessing. Usually we're the board of last resort. Everybody else has chopped and cut and, you know, modified, and you know, we're almost, you know, being asked to bless what every other board and commission has already blessed, in our own, according to our own mandates. And in this case, perhaps we have some of that, we don't have all of it. So what I'm hoping is we make the right decision, which we always try to do, but that it doesn't slow you down further. Because we have there are some uncertainties. You know, what I'd really hate to see, and I heard your draft settlement proposal. You know, what I'd really hate to see happen is for us to agree to this, and then your lawyers, the lawyers, change that, and then you're going to come back again and change it again, and you know. But again, you've chosen your path.
If we ruled major, he may be faced with that. If we ruled minor, he may be faced with that. We can speculate on this thing till the cows come.
Right. But normally we would, in that scenario, Cy, and again, it's not one that we've ever faced before, I don't think. We've never been asked for a decision on a modification when we're involved in the litigation. The board, the town is involved in the litigation. Without town council's
correct
consent and advice regarding, you know, perhaps even meeting in closed session, in executive session, to discuss that litigation.
The town council has cleared him.
Chicken and the egg, we wouldn't be here if town council didn't advise daytime government that they should post the meeting. So tacitly, they've approved this process, so perhaps we are making it.
Is there a difference between making a decision or making a determination? Because he's asked us for a determination.
Yeah.
Not a decision.
All right, Bob.
What it leads to a decision, sir.
Hmm?
It leads to a decision.
Yeah.
The determination, in essence, is translated into a decision.
But I'm going to take myself right back to something very elementary. I'm looking at a garage that was there before, and I'm looking at a garage that's there now, and the question in my mind, is it major or minor change? And I hear all this other stuff.
Yeah, that's a personal decision for each board member.
I think it is.
An informed,
that's
educated.
That's the determination we're being asked to do. He may run into problems as a result of that, but he's got to work all through that.
All right, so.
And if it's something happens, he may have to come back here.
I go back to it just so that we get it right. Can we have a consensus as to if our inclination is to determine that this is a minor modification, would we add conditions to it? Or just say, no, it's minor, and leave it like it is?
My position is no.
No what?
On conditions.
No conditions.
No conditions.
I would have a major problem with that.
I had no issue with conditions. I mean, I wouldn't want to see a list of 20 conditions on it, but if somebody is concerned that, okay, that driveway, he should go back to the selectmen and have that taken care of, have it taken off the books, that approval. I would not be opposed to that as a condition.
Final sign-off of CONCOM?
Yes. That's the other.
That's final sign off, which is forthcoming, but make sure that's
not an issue. And other condition, I guess, it would be is that these plans or the survey plot plan, the new plot plan, supersedes what was attached or the attachment to the previous decision. I don't know if that is considered a condition or it's just we make note of it.
Well,
I think we have to
Maybe I'm over-lawyering this too much, but we're a party to the litigation. Will we make one of the conditions that this dismisses the litigation?
I agree totally. Because we are in the middle of that.
I don't know. You tell me as an attorney. I don't know if we can dismiss any litigation as a board. We can't dismiss litigation.
We're not dismissing it.
We're the client.
Right.
Essentially, the board, the town board is the client. We're proceeding to make a determination that has been presented to us will resolve the litigation, that will dismiss the town from litigation, save the town money and legal expense and cost, as well as the other parties.
I think we have to make a determination tonight as to whether it's major or minor. I mean, like he's saying, we're going to bounce it back there and bounce it here and bounce it. Let's make that determination. I don't think we need conditions, but if that's what it takes to make a determination, I'll go along with it.
I mean, I'm a little uncomfortable with the dismissing the litigation.
It was just a question.
Only because now we have an interest in it, and we're shaping that modification to serve ourselves as well.
But you're looking, Eric, for using the word dismissing litigation. All we're asking for, I think, in the addition on this is that the parties involved come to a middle of the ground solution, as David suggests, that all parties are
absolved.
Maybe that's a much better word.
Because
we can't very well dismiss our own impact in the decision.
We can't.
Just not highlight it.
Well, that's what I said. I don't think we can get involved with any dismissal of it or anything.
Right.
That's between the attorneys. Whether it be town council and Mr. Wise's attorney
and the
complainant's attorney.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's up to them.
Why don't we try, I guess we'd have to do this by motion, wouldn't we?
Yes.
Why don't we try to work together on crafting a motion that we might be able to live with and try to get this to a vote before halftime?
I'm up for that. Yeah, I thought you were going to say before next meeting.
One of the hardest discussions with that, really.
Yeah.
Maybe it shouldn't be, but.
And it maybe shouldn't be, too. But I think John's right, and David's right, too. This has got a little quirk to it with being involved with litigation.
Yeah, you know, with everything that's gone on, yeah, just at this board level, with us, yeah, having come back and revote and having to, you know, drag them through the grinder even further.
Sure.
You know, I want to be cognizant of making sure we get this,
yeah,
right, or as right as we can.
As right as we can.
And do our best.
Absolutely.
So that somebody doesn't call and say, hey, by the way,
what are you doing?
Yeah. Anyway, so with the board's permission, I'll try to see if I can.
I was just going to show the attorney's
yeah,
preparation of some conditions that we can.
All right. Have. So, I move that the Board of Appeals grant the request of the petitioner, Tom Wise, on behalf of the Wise Living Trust, that to modify, to consider the request for modification,
yeah,
a minor modification of the special permit granted by this board previously.
Yeah. And as referenced?
As referenced on the drawings provided, stamped by Meridian and Associates.
Yep.
And stamped by Kevin Danahy, dated
9/14/15.
Well, the stamp 9/14/15,
yep,
plans March 25. Oh no, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
9/14/15.
Yeah,
revised
9/14/15. Yeah. And then
sheet number two.
Sheet two of two, I think, is the only relevant sheet, really.
It was two sheet two sheet of two, so make sure.
Oh.
Well, there's two sheet two of two.
Yeah, so
yeah,
you gotta get the right one.
So sheet two of two, I guess. If we're gonna.
Well, mark it Exhibit A.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah, it's yeah.
The second page of the three page paper submission
that,
of the Mylar.
Okay, well, why don't we just clarify and say it's the plan that eliminates the driveway on the west side of the
domicile.
Garage.
It adds,
yeah,
the driveway and the garage.
And
on
adds,
the
adds
east
a three bay garage.
Garage.
Yeah.
Two
and adds a three bay garage.
Okay.
Yeah.
With the following conditions. Formal sign off and approval by Conservation Commission of the
proposed
amended plan.
Yeah. So that
one
previously referenced, yeah.
A formal notification from the Board of Selectmen relating to the curb cut or the abandonment of the curb cut.
Abandonment would be good.
That's a good word. Abandonment, yeah. Abandonment of the
second curb cut.
Of the second
curb cut.
Of the curb cut that's been removed as reflected in,
right,
Exhibit A. Mm-hmm.
Second curb cut that was approved on the west side,
yep,
of the domicile.
Do we want to add? Well, I mean, to me that's enough.
I'm satisfied with it. I think if we.
I'm trying to think. If that is done, there's no reason that we would have to wait. There's no reason that we would not be willing to wait for the resolution with the three attorneys. So it's like a almost like a non-condition.
Right. I think it's.
I mean, By approving this and those,
right,
other two things that he's got to do pretty much anyway,
yeah,
wrapped up in a bow with a bow on it, satisfies the conditions of the resolution to the litigation. So
I can't do anything until the litigation is settled anyway, regardless of what you guys do.
We hope.
Well, right.
Right.
So
I need to do that.
This isn't his last stop,
right,
in other words. when typically it is, but this isn't your last stop.
No.
So I think if we limit it to those two conditions, I think we've...
Yeah, I don't have a...
Done what we need to do.
I think so.
Right.
I think so. I don't think we should get involved with the litigation aspect.
Do I need to restate that motion, or are we good now with those two conditions?
No, I'm good with it.
Okay.
Two conditions.
So moved.
So moved.
Seconded. You seconded.
Seconded.
John seconded. Any further comment? We have a motion on the floor to consider this a minor change to the special permit that was previously issued. All those in favor, raise your hand. Okay. As stated, we will write that up. And again, I believe, yeah, there is no appeal period or anything on that. We will just write this up as an amendment to the original special permit and file it with the town clerk. And
I'm going to call it a modification.
Yeah, call it a
I'll title it as a I'll write it. I'll title it as a modification for your review.
Sure. Well, yeah.
And both for the board's review, but ultimately for your final sign off.
Yeah. Yeah, and I will sign it off as, you know, usually as soon as I get it, but I'm down here the next day with it. And
does he need a stamp copy of those? Or do we just want to
give
him a stamp?
I don't think so. I really don't think he does. I think we should attach a plan, and I will keep my plan here.
You have asked me to file the stamped architecture diagram.
Yeah. I think we gotta give him a stamped plan, Bob.
Yeah, I think we do.
Because what's he gonna file?
This is what I have to file.
What's he gonna file?
What's he gonna record?
He's gonna record the decision that we make, and I was gonna say the plan should be attached to the decision.
Yes.
And that's what would be filed.
This particular one, you're gonna stamp for him and give to him now?
I got another one for you, Bob, if you want another one.
I wasn't gonna stamp it at all, to be honest with you. What are we granting? A determination? It says granted, ZBA case number such and such. What are we granting? We made a determination that the change shown on this plan is a minor modification. And this plan will be attached to that. Hopefully we can keep that to a one-page decision, and this will be attached.
Try to keep it simple.
By
attaching that plan, so he's going to file the original decision along with the modification decision that we're going to write up.
Right, that amends it.
And he's going to file this plan.
And he's going to file that plan, which amends, that supersedes the other plan that was...
So in that original decision, it referenced a set of plans.
It did.
And the modification is going to reference a new set of plans.
Right.
It's your understanding that we shouldn't stamp a set of plans and give them to them with the modification?
You know, I don't know exactly what the changes are on the set of plans, other than it would be the three-car garage, etc. Obviously,
the curb cut, the wall.
And
the wall.
Yeah, but that's on the site plan.
Yes, but that's, right now, this plan... Number two, the middle page.
I don't have a problem with it. If I'm not considering this,
it's up to you, Bob. You're the chair, so
it
I'm
is.
I'm making a
it
suggestion.
Is. It is revised. Okay, so why don't we add to it? We noted the site plan with a date. Why don't we note the new architectural plans dated August 30th, 2015, and attach those to it also.
So the stamp.
The
site plan. Plot plan?
Yep.
And
the architectural plans.
And so
I've got the ones you originally stamped.
Okay.
So
we don't need those anymore, though.
Well,
right?
That's what I'm asking, because if I need to file them with the original submission and then file this.
No, because this is an update.
This is updated, exactly.
This will update it, yes.
So I do need both the plot plan and the architectural plan stamped.
Right. So.
Yep.
That has to go
with the decision. In essence,
right.
The modification.
We didn't make reference to this in our vote.
No, we didn't.
Can we all agree that we're going to add this in
Yeah.
As well, reference to this, as well as the plans and the vote that we just made?
Absolutely.
All right, then we don't have to re-vote and spend any more time.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
All right.
This isn't, yeah, this is under other business. It's, we decided it was a major and minor modification.
Tom, thanks for your patience.
And I think we're just clarifying it with the referencing of the plans here. Oh, okay, so we'll do that. And as I say, I was not going to stamp those and give him a copy as I did when we gave him the special permit, or when we approved the special permit. These will just go with the decision, the architectural plan and the site plan. What do you think? I have no problems. I mean, it's, you know.
Well, what we've done in the past, like the last few years, is we've always put the town that I think is looking for a stamp on.
Stamp. I have no problems. I'll stamp it. We'll give you a copy.
Yeah,
I don't think they are done by stamping.
Yeah. I want to, you probably want to record the stamp ones.
Okay. Why don't we do that? It'll just make it easier down the road. Hopefully. I'll need a set. It'll help us if we make anything easier, right, Tom?
You're going to have this set. Oh, okay.
I'll keep your sets out. Let me
keep the whole set.
Well, you're gonna. I need two, and I'll give it. I'll give Mr. Wise my set.
Yeah.
So I'll need a set when I sign the modification and bring it down to town hall.
Robert, Mr. Redford.
Yes.
Mr.
Okay. Thank you. Well, that's the plot plan, architectural plans too.
I don't have extras in that.
That's all right. No, I'll get Cy as a set. Thank you.
Received 10 copies.
Okay, and that
five.
Was. Why don't I just write up about minor modification? Okay, Mr. Wise. I'm sorry.
No problem whatsoever.
Yeah, sorry there. And actually, what I should do is stamp these and give these to you, Kim, so they go into the we don't have a project file with us tonight, but
that's okay, I'll do.
Yeah, they should get into the project file immediately. Thank you. Okay. Okay, I think I'll clean that up.
Kathy must be happy that she set that up.
I think we're all, I think we're all set with you tonight anyway, Mr. Wise.
Okay.
Hopefully we won't have to see you back again.
No,
and I'm sure you don't want to.
No offense taken on that one.
Yeah. There you go. Okay.
Thank you, gentlemen. Okay.
Thanks for your patience.
I appreciate the dialogue and discussion about it. It's not a simple thing. I appreciate the time.
Takes a while sometimes.
Good luck.
Yes.
Yeah. Other business. We do have some minutes to go through tonight. Did everybody have a chance to read them? Any comments on those? Let's take them in order. And we can do those of August 6th, 2015. Any comments from board members on those? I had a couple myself. In the first paragraph, the zoning board, if we can correct that spelling in board, there was a space instead of an A there, at least on my copy. It's been corrected now. Okay, I see it's been corrected, yep. And a variance under Jack Sullivan, who seeks a variance on behalf of the property owner. Can we put that in commas after variance, comma, on behalf of the property owner, comma, under section six? That's what I thought anyway, it should be in there. And then in the, I think the only one I have, I don't remember anything else in there. In the second paragraph, Kim, in the second sentence after the word the, we had the hearing, in between the and hearing, can you insert opening of the, has requested that the opening of the hearing. That's, and I wanted to clarify that. I know I did that night, that we were postponing the opening of the meeting.
Probably why you added D to the word postpone.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you. Other than that, I didn't have any comments. Anybody else? Comments? No?
Motion to approve the minutes of August 6, 2015 as amended.
Second, all those in favor of the motion? All approved. Thank you. We have the minutes of August 20th, 2015. Again, I'll go first. I had a couple of comments. Let's see, missed the Molden on the. Just a clarification on the second paragraph, Kim. You see the underlined section in the after door, could we put a comma in there? It's just a clarification, comma. The porch would need to be extended. You know, it's a separate thought on that one. And let's see, Mr. Riffin, then we had Mr. Trinello asked why the design needed to encroach in the setbacks. Ms. Tomey said this was to prevent the molding, not be grout. It was all convoluted. I don't know if you had any thoughts on that, David. It was your statement, but I noted.
It was to prevent the molding from?
It was to avoid impacting
grouted.
The molding around the front door. That's all I said. I just tried to clarify that and say Ms. Tomey said it was to avoid impacting the molding around the front door. If you're comfortable,
yep, that's fine.
And then, let's see, you go down to about four more paragraphs where it starts, Mr. Redfern read the real estate of the dwelling. Just take it out. I don't know what it means.
I don't know what it means.
So, I think that was it on that for my comments, yeah. Any other comments from people?
I would go over to other business on page, I guess it's page three.
Okay.
Second paragraph.
Mm-hmm.
The start of that second sentence says, "His planned on tearing down."
His
either he planned on tearing down the present dwelling.
For an A, yeah.
His plan doesn't go together.
Right. His plan, or, yeah, he
his
planned.
He planned.
Right. I agree, Cy. I didn't catch that. I would agree. Okay. No further comments. I'd take a motion.
I move to accept the minutes of August 20th, 2015 as amended.
Second.
Second by Eric. All those in favor? Okay, thank you. And the minutes of September 3rd, 2015. That's pretty short. I went through them. I did not have any comments on them. So as far as I was concerned, they were as good as they stood.
None here either.
I didn't have any.
Okay. If no comments on that, I would accept a motion.
Move to approve the minutes of September 3rd, 2015.
Second.
And second. All those in favor? Okay. Thank you. Very good. We're pretty much, that's what we have on our agenda tonight.
Motion to adjourn.
I would accept a motion to adjourn. David, do I hear a second?
I'll second that.
Second that. All those in favor? Thank you so much, everybody.
Clean up my mess here.